Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Zeke, Dogumentary TV, YouTube channel for dog lovers. If you guys haven't already, subscribe to the channel. If you would, please, if you enjoyed the content, hit the like button. What else can we do? What else can you do for me? Yeah, also, if you really like the content, become a channel member, help me. I'm gearing up for big things to happen in 2023. So I'm excited. I think you guys should be too. If you love dogs, you should be excited as well. Anyway, there's been a story where there is some news going around. It maybe happened about a month ago. A dog, a Great Pyrenees, took on a pack of coyotes, and legend has it that he killed 8 of them. When I first heard this story, you know, to me, I'm always interested in, if you tell me it happened, you had 8 dead coyotes, I'm just going to accept that that's what happened. But I'm always interested in the logistics. Well, how did it happen? How does one dog kill 8 dogs? So I was looking on the internet, and I found this interview that the Great Pyrenees, his name is Casper. His owner recounts the whole story in a video. I think we should take a look at it and kind of do what we do, give it some analysis, and kind of look at this, the underlying information that's being delivered in the video. All right, guys, let's watch this video real quick.
They're clearing brush, and the first time the coyotes were out in the cul-de-sac was about 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock. And they did what coyotes usually do when you come out, they ran away. And that's good. You know, we threw some things at them and yelled at them. And they were just typical coyotes running away, looking over their shoulder and kind of taunting you, but still running away, right? And then about 2:30, 3 o'clock, somewhere in there, I was woken up by the dogs barking and came out here, and
I'm assuming he means 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock in the morning.
Casper and Daisy had the sheep backed up in that corner over there, and
so real quick, he said Casper and Daisy, so they're actually 2 dogs with the sheep. Up until I saw this video, people had only mentioned the one dog, the dog that was badly injured. So obviously, the 2 dogs. Just fighting off these. I don't know what the other dog did, but they're 2 dogs, not 1 dog. Let's go on.
It's just 5 or 6 of them there at the time, and Daisy was staying close to the sheep, and Casper was out a little further out front this way. And when I got about somewhere around here, there were coyotes inside the pen and coyotes outside. I wasn't, like I said, wasn't really afraid that they were going to attack me or anything, but they weren't responding. They were focused on Casper, I think, as much as anything. And he charged into the middle of them and killed some right in here, and then came out. They jumped out of the fence. Some ran that way, and some ran this way over the fence, and he just came out the fence here and killed more, and then they had a fight all up and down this creek, and it wasn't a short thing. It was half hour, it was a while that this was going on. And he just, I went out to try to get him back and try to make sure he was okay, and just eventually couldn't find him. So the next day we thought
real quick, let's set the scene real quick. So obviously there are a lot of coyotes. I live in coyote country. I live in Southern California. You know, I have seen as many as 10 or 15 coyotes. But that's not typical, and I don't think that is it's not typical. But I have seen a large pack, and it sounds like, I think this is Decatur, Georgia. It says Decatur. I don't know what state, but so it sounds like, if you're saying there's 5 or 6 in and there's some out, anything more than, 4 or 5 coyotes together is kind of a large pack. So obviously I don't know how hungry this pack is. I don't know what they need, what they want, what the conditions are, where they are right now. But it seems like, they seem to be kind of determined to get at these sheep. And that's why they stood and fight. Because typically I would think, you know, the coyotes would just go elsewhere. They're not looking, they don't, typically, you know, wild animals aren't looking for a fight. But maybe because they decided the number of coyotes that they were, and they just felt emboldened and felt that they could take the dogs.
We could find him. We thought he must have been killed.
Oh, what I stopped it was because I wanted to say, like, at some point, man, like, are you going to help your dog? That's what I think. Like, I get it, man. Like, it's coyotes. It's whatever. But me personally, like, if it's coyotes out there, bro, and I'm saying they're not attacking me, they're not thinking about me, they seem to be fearful of me. It's late at night, you know, I'm going to grab a stick or something, rocks. I'm going to try to chase off some of these coyotes. He seemed to be pretty content with just letting his dog do all the work. And that's cool, too. I know people have that mentality. I'm me. It ain't got nothing to do with being a dog person, because dog people, he's a dog person, obviously. But I would have helped my dog out. Like, you know, that's just what I would have done. But, you know, everybody ain't me, so let's keep going.
And so we were looking for him. And if he wasn't killed, we figured he was hurt, and we knew he was hurt because we found parts of his tail and blood and other things. And so we were worried about him. And we put out a post on Facebook and let neighbors know, because we didn't want anybody to run into an injured dog. And the neighbors came out and helped us look, and we found more coyotes dead, and still didn't find him. And 2 days later, he showed up back here in the pen, in the little chicken hutch, and popped his head out, and he looked like death. I mean, he looked terrible. He came back home and he just kind of looked at me like, boss, just stop looking at how bad I look. Just take care of me. And
that's a good dog.
So my daughter and I cleaned him up and didn't go to church.
So the other videos I've been watching, they've called this dog a Great Pyrenees. And this video right here, he's titled a herd dog. That eye makes me wonder if he's mixed with something else, like maybe some kind of cattle dog, Australian cattle dog, Australian shepherd, something. I don't know, but I don't know if he can be great, a pure Great Pyrenees with that eye. I've never seen that before. But if you guys know anything about Great Pyrenees, is that eye an indication that he's got some other mix in him, or he might be crossbred with something? And if so, what would you think that he would be crossbred with? And you could just leave that in the comment section.
Cleaned him up and went looking for veterinarians. And ultimately, it took a day before we got Lifeline. Once we called Lifeline called up to the vets. It's the emergency vet that they work with, and said, this is a Lifeline case. And from that point on, everything was taken care of. They were great. So, you know, he's had a few surgeries, I guess, wound care surgery kind of thing. And I think one of them, they've closed up one of his wounds now, and he had to have his tail amputated. And at the same time, it's been about a month and he's looking great compared to where he was. You know, there's not much question about him surviving now. It's a question of what his quality of life will be. And so he'll be able to move around. He's big and strong and healthy. We don't know if he'll ever be out with his sheep again.
And that's a pretty amazing story. I'm very, very proud of Casper. He did an amazing thing. Whatever transpired that over those few days, he did what a dog is supposed to do. When I first heard the story, when I heard other accounts of the story, little pieces here and there, I'm always about logistics, so I was a little skeptical. Didn't necessarily understand why, you know, coyotes were hanging around while other coyotes are being killed. But if I'm listening to the way this guy tells a story, and I'm going to try to reconstruct it in my mind. I think what happened was, for whatever reason, the conditions, the pack, the coyote pack was large. They were emboldened by their size and number. They took on a dog that they probably in all other situations would have left alone, trying to get at those sheep. And then probably what happened in the course of the fighting, Casper got so wounded at some point the sheep, the coyotes probably thought, oh, we'll just eat him. You know, like he's, you know, half dead anyway. So he fought. And obviously he survived and he managed to kill 8 coyotes. You know, that's a great story. That's what legends are made of. that's the kind of, you know, that's the kind of battle story that, you know, warriors dream about. I went into the battle. It was 100 men and it's just me and my gun. And I was brutalized. I was battered, but I came out alive and I'm here today to tell the story. And Casper's here to tell the story. So he did an amazing thing. It's an amazing story. It's one of the wonderful things about dogs. You know, dogs at their essence do what they're supposed to do when they're healthy and happy and properly cared for. They will fight for the death of, for you. And that's not just, you know, typical pit bulls and Cane Corsos and other gladiator breeds. You know, there are a lot of livestock guardian breeds out there. Some terriers that are put their life on the line for you as well. Anyway, guys, what's your thoughts on Casper, his story? Do you believe it? Do you not believe it? Yeah, let me know. Leave a comment in the comment section. I'll be checking that out. I'll talk to you guys again very soon. All right? Peace.